Hello everyone and welcome to my build video. I just started. I think I started 2 hours ago. Starting to clean up. Got finally my whole desk cleaned up. It doesn't look really nice. I really need to replace it. It's one I ever built myself. So I really need to build new desks. So cleaned up everything. Cleaned up the floor. There's still a bag there that doesn't need to be there. Power supplies, splitters. Everything cleaned up. And when you start cleaning up, you really discover how much crap is there and stuff. Also, I got all my screens right here. You see 3 screens. There's a 4th. There's still a 5th there. I still got one in storage too that I don't use currently. But you clean up and you discover how much freaking cable you got. It's really insane. All the cables. It's not healthy. Holy. So there's my PS4 that I really need to get set up. As soon as possible, so I can at least stream tonight from the PS4. There's my main case. I haven't started even on that. I still need to do that. Start working on that. I prepped that case for the main board from that one to go in that case. So that's the plan out. There's a hot swap that came out. That's a big PC. That's connected to my TV and stuff. Put all my mainboards and stuff, router, headset, mouse, it's all there for now. So, a lot of work to do. It's surprising how many cables I had up back there. Cleaned up all the cables, got another PC here. there's so many PCs, that's everywhere. This is my PC that's used for rendering. The edit videos. There's no Photoshop on this one. I have it on the other one that I'm not going to be placed back. So I need to get Photoshop on this one too. So I can make some nice stuff if you need it too. So yeah, a lot of work to do. At least clean up is getting well. I'm going to see now quickly to set up my PS4. So for streaming for tonight for Horizon Zero Dawn. So yeah, we'll be back when I have more stuff done. Alright, quick update on the home farm. Starting to run out of daylight here. Just past 4 o'clock. Got my screens back in position. There's a few cables. There's one USB extension cable for my mouse. Gamerig, that's a cable for charger for my phone. Headset. PS4 controller right underneath there. PS4 is already running. Completely connected up. First screen there. My PS4 has moved now to this position. It exactly fits with my screen. Underneath it there, so that's perfectly. Cannot have it any better there. So PS4 is running, connected up to the internet. My router is right back there too, right next to it. My PC for my editing is already put back in position. I haven't put a power cable into there yet. I think that's a really tricky one to connect that one. Because the power supply on that one is not that good. It usually, when I switch it on, it completely kills all my power here. There's some special trick to do there for it. Yeah, got that all back in position. Of course, my gaming PC. That's the thing I'm gonna start on tomorrow on. Because I'm, like I said, running out of time here. But at least I can restreaming tonight Horizon Zero Dawn, so we're ready for that completely. So yeah, coming on tomorrow, so we'll be recording some more tomorrow, and you will see that then again, of course, after this was the magic of editing, you'll see it straight after this, so back tomorrow at least with more updates, in this case, in a few seconds for you guys. Alright then, day 2, working on PC. I've cleaned out that one completely. Mainboard is out of it, cooler is out of it. The fans in front of it are out. Hard drives are still in, power supply are still in there. Also cleaned out all the dust filters that are in here. And they were quite dusty for like half a year. The 1080. Indeed, that was a 780. And surprisingly, this thing is not that dirty. I never cleaned it before this one. And there's hardly any dust in it. Except for the fan a bit, try to clean it up a bit. I need to clean it a little bit more, as you see, there's a little bit more dust in there. Old mainboard, got a new cooler, already had this lying around. It's an Mastery Pro 4 from Cooler Master. Already had this lying around for a while because my old water cooler was a pair. I thought was dying, but it's still fine, still in use, so I didn't have it need this cooler. Now it's useful to put it on this mainboard for it. So that one is gonna go all in that case. I don't have a hard drive for that one. I don't have a graphics card for that one. But as soon I maybe get this one ready, get a capture card. I'm gonna use my basically my 780 can go in there because then I don't need it in my main PC, so I can move it in there then. So that's where I'm at. I got the IO shield. I got here the these are the old breakers for my water cooler. That's lying back there. All the fans are lying there and stuff. Magnetic tray? No, I don't have it. Just using a soup bowl. I needed to use something for it to keep it apart. So that's where I'm at now at day two. I'm gonna put this board in there. It was, by the way, really tight on the memory, but it just fits. I thought I'll put the fan on, then the memory in. That didn't work out. So that's where I'm at now. Gonna put the main board in, put the IO shield in first, of course. Tie everything down, hook everything up. And we'll be back at update then. So, see you in a few seconds. Alright, I got another small update for today. That's the last for day two at least. I see got the front fans in it. I hope they're turning the right way. There's no flow direction on these fans, so but by looking at this, how this is curving here, I think that will be have the flow direction right. I cannot find anywhere the flow direction. The really nice thing about these fans is they're nice rubber pads on it, so no noise of any vibrations of this on the fans there. Another nice thing really is the cables here. Usually you run out of space for cables. My cable is now running all the way down there. If you cannot see, they're all running on the back, all the way up to here, and they are really, really long. That's a really good thing. They're really long. Maybe a bit too long, because I'm now having the issue of where could I leave all the rest of it? So they're really long. And then also still this needs to go in here. That's one controller. I need to not put another one in. I have six fans, and the controller can support four, or five. No, five fans. It can support five fans, and I got six fans. So I need to put one additional controller in here to make it work. But it looks to be that there's a bridge in between it, so I might not need another long cable for this. Anyway, I got the fans in. The last thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put these trays back in. The trays where the slides can be in for the hard drives, so I can see a little bit more about the space what I have. And that's gonna be it then I'm gonna do for today. We'll start putting the main board in tomorrow, so I can see also a little bit more with the cables how I'm gonna do all that. But again, quite decent space. These cables, I haven't done anything. Just removed everything, the sled drives and stuff out of there. So those are still hanging there. I don't have any shorter ones. These are really shortest ones I got, so have to deal with it. I don't know why I have this one drive in it. It might be useful anyways at some point. So can't do that. It's the last thing for day two. I'm gonna do tomorrow, day three, Wednesday. I'm gonna do the rest. At least the rest. I'm gonna put in the main board, CPU in it, memory in it. And hopefully I can find a way to mount a radiator like the way I want it. I want it on top. I want to have the fans right here, the two fans, RGB fans, and the radiator I want to have on the other side. So the issue a little bit is with the screws, because I tried it before and there's a little bit of a height difference here, and that was the only reason the screws didn't fit. They were not long enough for it. So hopefully I can figure a way it out, because I want to have a pull configuration. I can always clean the radiator easy if I want to. But for now, yeah, have dust filters in it. They were quite dirty, clean as well, she saw it before. So next thing is gonna be doing tomorrow. So day three coming up straight after this. Hello everyone and welcome to day three of my PC build. I woke up really, really late. Apparently I might get sick or something because I slept a lot more than normal I do. So I don't have a lot of time. This is basically the only video from day three now that I'm making. Mainboard is in, CPU is in. Already hooked up a few cables, audio, USB, USB 3, power cable for the CPU. And mainboard is in. I ran into one problem. I had no screws to mount the mainboard. So I went to the shop, got some screws, got two types of screws. He said, because I didn't know which one exactly I got. So I got these two screws and none of those fit. So what I had to do, I took out the screw, some screws out of the mainboard that was in before here that I used in the other case. Put the screws in there. Those screws fit in that one. And they don't fit in here. But the screws I have here, I now use a few of these on the other mainboard. And they fit also in there for some reason. So there's two types of thread fitting in the other case there to mount the mainboard. There's still a few in there that I prefer to swap out. Because this one is now with, I think, only 4 or 5 screws that I mounted it. Oh, 6 screws. It's with 6 screws stuck now, so basically there's another screw there, there, and there. There's no screw in it on top there. I have no screw in there yet, so there's still a few in there. That main mount is also missing one screw, so not really a huge problem. But I prefer to have it screwed down with most of them that I can. So, yeah, now I need to basically figure out where the cooler needs to go. See if I can get it working, how the radio needs to get the radiator mounted, get the fans mounted, and they were almost done. There needs a cable working. It's gonna be a lot of work, especially for the LED fans on front. So this is the only video for day 3. Day 4 tomorrow, I'm gonna have also less time tomorrow because I'm gonna get a haircut that tomorrow. So yeah. Also, that is gonna be less time, so I'm hoping to get it Friday working. I've been running up again and start streaming again on a Saturday evening, I hope. So that's it for day 3. I hope to be getting may hopefully even tomorrow. It will be really nice, but I don't count on it. So back in a sec, of course, with day 4. Alright, here we are, day 4 of my build. I'm really far now, I'm pretty much done. I tried the radio to mount the radiator here on top, but the radiator fits with it and the fans, but I cannot put the top cover on because this is not centered, as you can see. So that's a little bit of a problem, and there's a exactly here are brackets then from where the dust filter is sitting, and so it doesn't fit with it. So mounted is still back like this, and the fan's on the bottom. The cooler is back on it. Got the graphics card, the 780 is back in it, the 1080 is back in it, and you see this one actually has a support for it because so heavy. Just need to put in the power supply cables for those. So on the back there you cannot see, but all the hard drives are plugged in. Fan cables. There is so much cable here that it's really hard to find a place to work it all away. So this is the controller. This one is controlling the back fan and the two radiator fans. Then I have the front fans. Controlled right here. Here's the controller for that one. There's still this sticker on it, we'll remove it. Ooh, the peel off stickers. Ooh, there's another one on top, by the way. Oh, let's peel them off. There you go. It's not right, it's quite nice. Need to do a little bit of cable work here in the back still, as cables are not being used. Also here, trying to work away the cables.
quite hard. I had first them all right next to here, and I thought, wait, and then the LED colors won't come through it perfectly, so we'll move them towards here so they fit a lot better on that side. Need to work a little bit on the center cables to work those away. That's about it, and we can put everything, and it's pretty much done. And then we can start booting it up, the PC, and hopefully it's gonna work out and everything's gonna work. The main thing is fans. Hopefully they're turning the right way. If they're not, I need to unscrew all the fans and change them around, turn them around to make them spin the right way. There's no direction on it which way they flow, so I'm so hoping that I have them the right way, all the fans. So that's the update now. When I have everything is running, I will make another quick video at the end when all the LED is working, PC is running. Of course I need to install drivers for everything. At least for the mainboard drivers. And also by the way, I don't think you can see it now. Here's the memory. And here's the connection from the water cooling. I don't think you can really see it on there. I don't have a light here. Maybe I can turn it a little bit. You can see it maybe. There you go. It really just fits. It's not a lot of space left there. But at least it fits. So, and the name of the cooler is at least the right way. So, just gonna finish off the last bit for today then. Of course, after this quick video on when everything is running, I will see the end result. Alright, we are about 1.5 week later since the last recording I've done. That's the part just before of the video. Why it's taking so long before the ending? It's basically my mainboard is not working properly. It's not posting. I called Gigabyte yesterday. Basically, the problem is that the mainboard BIOS is from the beginning of this year, and the memory I have, so it's the memory that I have right here. I have another package of memory. This one should be compatible with Ryzen. Also not working because the BIOS is a little bit too old and doesn't support my 3200 megahertz memory. So I just came back from the post office for sending my mainboard away to Gigabyte. They will update my BIOS and then send it back to me. It can take about a week to 2 weeks time, depending if they can do it here in Holland. If they cannot do it here, then they need to send it back, send it to Germany, to Hamburg, and they need to do it there. But at least some update for now to finish off this video. I got a new desk and it's a really, really long one, as you see. Got it completely for free. Didn't cost me anything. I only had to do to pick it up. It's a lot bigger, a lot more space, a lot stronger than my old one, and looks way, way better. I can get my stuff way better. Of course, here is supposed to be my gaming rig. It's now standing in the corner with no mainboard. This is another PC that might be used as a streaming PC. It's basically the old mainboard for my gaming rig. That's now in this one. It only has no video card. It has no power supply in it. That's the only thing. PS4 is there. Router is there. And then here is a whole bunch of boxes. And then here's my other, basically my editing PC to edit my videos. I just started this up to finish off this video for the last bit I'm recording now. So. There is not more stuff coming in for here, so there will be another finished video. There will be another finished video coming out for this to finish to see the whole ending, how everything's gonna be here. So yeah, that one is still gonna come for that. So I'm hoping to back streaming about a week to 2 weeks again with my PC. Also for those that are watching my Evil Eye and my market videos, also those are completely delayed. Cannot bring them out because I have no PC to do it. I have that one, but that one is not set up to do anything. I don't think the hard drives are big enough,
Well, no, the hardware is big enough, but they're getting quite full of videos and stuff, so not really an option to do it in on that one. I not want to do it on that one. This screen is so small, I can basically not see anything. I'm so used to my 4K screen now, so yeah, that's why. So that was the last video to round up this whole build video for now. Of course, there will be a finished video coming out as soon as I have everything done on this. Also, by the way, this desk is really nice feature. I have some cable management underneath it, so I can work away the cables a little bit, so they're not all on the floor. Only cables now on the floor, yeah, the power supply cables. Because really they don't fit in there. Definitely that one, not one is not fitting in there, so that's really useful. Alright, so I'm finishing off this video. Like I said, there's coming another one out when everything is done and everything is running. So thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed this video. And I hope to be really soon back on streaming, because a lot of people are already starting to wonder, where the hell am I, what? For those already wondering where the hell I am, just follow me on Twitter or join my Discord channel, it's all down below in the description. And you'll see, and you'll see, you can read it there, all the updates, also on Twitter you can read all the updates, so. So then you know when I will be back. So thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. And hope to be back really soon. See you guys all really soon in the live channels. Bye bye.